Mrs. Pak, thank you for joining us here today in the European Parliament. You are an MEP, but you're also president of EPP Women. Could you perhaps explain to our viewers what you and your team have done to represent women in recent years?
What I'm doing here is working on the legislation, it's working on initiatives in the Parliament, but these initiatives are very often based on experiences and on work which we have done in our EPP organization. I have each year many meetings with women of all parties in the EPP, which does not mean only the EU member states. It means also the enlarged countries. And so we are helping them. It means Bosnia or Serbia or Croatia or Macedonia and so on, and Albania, on their way to the Union. Each year we have one topic on which we are focused more than on others. I remember in 2005 we spoke on measures against harmful traditional practices, which means the question of women in the Muslim countries. We have spoken on trafficking of women, and we try always at the end to have a resolution. A resolution which gives some ideas in which ways the different countries should tackle this problem. And these resolutions always find entrance in the EPP party documents. We have, on the other hand, spoken increase 2 years ago on adult learning. And then the year before, we spoke on women and poverty in the European Union.
But this year, you're focusing in particular on women and the economic crisis, because indeed women risk being the worst affected, for example, shortening their maternity leave for fear of losing jobs. So what do you propose to help women sustain their role in society amidst this financial crisis?
I'm sure that one of the things which are very much important is education. That's clear. And on the other hand, it's also clear that we should take care that all the achievements in maternity, combining it with labour market, we should keep it. We should not give up.
Now, what would you say to criticism, especially from the socialists, who say that the EPP does not have a gender equality issue, that the EPP has a paternalistic approach, and that the EPP wants to get women back into the kitchen?
Women are more than women in labour market. We have women in kitchen, so to say, and we have women who want to combine it. And if we see the daily life of our modern young women, they want to combine it more and more. They want to have kids. They want to have time for the kids. They want to have a man who is also a husband, who is also engaged in childcare. So all these things are really in the focus of the EPP. So we have not to be educated by the PSE. We do it in different paragraphs, in different articles, because it is something which has to be seen in all kind of political work. Everybody can influence if he or she tries to get the best politician, and they have a choice. They can choose between the socialists, the liberals, the left, the right, and the Christian Democrats and the EPP. And I think the best choice is the EPP.